Hello friends, in this video, let us discuss the star and delta connected systems. So in the interviewer may ask you why the alternators are connected in star and why most of the three-phase induction motors and three-phase loads are connected in delta. So in this video, we shall understand what is the purpose of the star connection and the delta connection and what are the advantages and the connection used in the power system equipments like alternator, transformer and the three-phase induction motors. So in this video we shall discuss all this. So first I will start with the comparison between the star and delta connected systems, in which we study their connections in the alternators and the transformers and the three-phase loads as well as the single-phase loads. So in the star connected system, the similar ends are connected together. So if I say there are three phases like this. Now, if I connect the similar ends, either you may connect these ends or you may connect these ends. So, if I connect the similar ends, then this connection will become a star connection, and here you can give the supply RYB. Now, similarly, what I do here is I will take other three phases. Now, here what I do is I connect the dissimilar ends, that means I will connect this end with this end. So this is one connection and this is the other connection, and this connection can be connected here. So this connection is your delta connection. So where the dissimilar ends are connected and here the similar ends are connected. And in the star connected system, the phase voltage Vp will be equal to 1/2-3 times the line voltage. So let me say this is the star connection and we am giving the terminals R, Y and B. So here this is the neutral point in the star connection. So from the neutral point to any phase of the system will give you the phase voltage, and between two phases it will give you the line voltage. And here your phase voltage will be equal to 1/√3 times VL, whereas in the delta connected system, so let me say this is again I'll connect here the three phases, so R, Y and B, and here you will be witnessing this voltage and this voltage, that is all are same, that is the phase voltage. Here the phase voltage will be equal to the line voltage in the delta connected system, that is there is no neutral point in the delta connected system like your star connected system to distinguish between the phase and the line. So here you will be having the voltage, phase voltage will be equal to the line voltage, but here the phase voltage is 1/√3 times of the VL. So as the phase voltage is lesser in the star connected system compared to the phase voltage in the delta connected system, most of your alternators, or you can say all the alternators, are usually connected in the star connection, because as the voltage of the phase is reduced for the same line voltage, let me say the alternator is having or carrying the same line voltage, so for the same line voltage the star connection alternator will reduce the number of turns per phase, and it will reduce the insulation. So because of these two advantages in the star connected system, all the alternators maximum or most, or you can say all the alternators are usually connected in the star connection, because in the star connection the phase voltage is lesser than the line voltage, and the lesser voltage will facilitate in the advantage of a low number of turns per phase as well as lesser insulation. So this is the reason you can say why the alternators are connected in the star connection. Now if we talk about the currents, so here your currents will be I, line current will be equal to I phase current. So whatever the phase current is flowing here, it will be equal to the line current. So line current will be equal to phase current, but here your line current and the phase currents are the different. So here you can see your phase current will be equal to 1 by root 3 times of your line current, that is IL. Now, as there is a presence of neutral point here, this star connected system will facilitate the neutral wire can be carried to the load end. So you can have a neutral wire which can be carried to the load end, and where you can connect your lighting loads, where you can connect your lighting loads as well as power loads, or you can say the unbalanced loads. So the lighting loads and the power loads are the unbalanced loads. So a balanced load is nothing but, if I say this is a system, three phases load, and if I say this is a three phase load, the balanced load is defined as the size or the magnitude of all the three phases must be same, and there should be the angle of 120 degrees between each two phases, then it is termed as a balanced load. Now here in the lighting loads or the power loads, we are using just, in the lighting loads we require a neutral line and we require a phase line. So your lighting loads can be connected in between these phase line as well as the neutral line. So any phase line and the neutral line, the lighting loads are connected in between these two lines, and the power circuit can be connected between the lines. So that is why this arrangement can also be termed as the three wire, there is a three phase four wire system. This is three phase four wire system because this is one wire, this is the second wire, third wire and four wire, but we are having three phases. The neutral is going to the load end, but in the delta connected system there is no such concept of neutral. So that is why this connection is not used to facilitate our loads in the households. Now the other difference is, so this neutral point, it can be connected to the earth. So it can be connected to the earth. Now as it can be connected to the earth, the relays and the protective devices in a star connected system can be used to protect the system or the three phase system from the ground faults. So it protects your system from the ground faults as the neutral can be connected to the earth, because you might see in the switchgear and protection there will be a concept of the restricted earth protection. So restricted earth protection relay. So in that you will be using your neutral wire for protecting your system. So if you want to know more about this, you can Google it, so that you can have the restricted earth protection relay. And here there is no concept of the neutral, so this system cannot be used to ensure the protection of the system in which it is employed. And the last difference is, so your delta connections are mostly preferred in the transformers which are operating small low voltage three phase motors, or you can say this delta connection is best suited for rotary converters. Now what are these rotary converters? So the rotary converter is a type of electrical machine, you can say it's a type of electrical machine which acts like a mechanical rectifier, inverter and frequency converter. It acts like a mechanical rectifier, inverter, or you can say the frequency converter. So it is a mechanical rectifier and not a electrical rectifier, remember this. So this delta connection system is best suited for these rotary converters, and your three phase induction motors are mostly delta connected, as well as your three phase loads are usually delta connected, because in case of unbalance in the load, that means the magnitude of any phase is reduced compared to the two phases, or you can say the phase angle between them has got shifted, then you can say it is an unbalanced load. So in case of any unbalanced load, there is a flexibility in addition or removal of a load on a single phase. You can remove or add the load on a single phase such that you can go for a balanced system in the, that means you can overcome the unbalanced load in the delta connection. So these are the basic comparison. Now we shall discuss how a balanced three phase load in a delta system can be connected to the star and vice versa. So here any balanced star connected system can be completely replaced by an equivalent delta connected system, or similarly any balanced delta connected system can be completely replaced by an equivalent star connected system. So let us take a star connected system and replace it with a delta connected system. So I'll say I'm having a balanced star connected load system. So I'm having a balanced star connected load, and I'm having the impedance of magnitude Z in each phase as well as the power factor cos phi in each phase. So in your each phase, the impedance of magnitude Z and the power factor is cos phi, so it can be given by Z angle phi. So here I am having Z angle phi, and this can be replaced, this impedance of magnitude Z and power factor angle cos phi can be replaced, that is the power factor cos phi can be replaced in the, replaced by an equivalent delta connected system by 3Z with the power angle cos phi, that is the power factor cos phi. So this Z phi can be replaced by 3Z with power factor cos phi in the delta connected system. This is in the star connected system. That means you can write here each phase as 3Z phi, this is 3Z phi. So let us see how the relation we got. So here you can see I phase will be equal to I line and V phase will be equal to 1 by 2 3 times VL. So here if I see your Z phase will be equal to Z phase in the star connected system, it will be equal to V phase upon I phase. So this can be given by 1 by root 3 VL upon IL. Now similarly in the delta connected system, your Z phase can be given by V phase upon I phase, and here it is root 3 times VL upon IL. So from here if you compare these two equations, you can see this, if I say this is ZS for star and let me say this is ZD for delta. So here you can see if I multiply this with 3, this 3ZS with 3, here also we will get 3. So this can be written as root 3 into root 3. So root 3 gets cancelled. That means if you compare these two equations, you can see here your ZD will be equal to 3ZS. That means you can also say your ZS will be equal to 1 by 3ZD. So this is the conversion you can do whether you are having a equal, that is a balanced star connected system or a balanced delta connected system, so that you can have a equivalent replacement of those systems. Now the other way is we are having the formula which you have studied in your first year. So what we do here is, here I'll replace it, here I'll say I'm having impedance, this is one impedance and this is one impedance and this is the other impedance. So what I do here is, if I say you this is the point A, B and C, so to get this impedance, what I do here is I multiply this impedance upon, I sum all three impedance. So that is to get this, let me say this is ZR. So to get ZR, what you do here is you multiply the resistance of, or the impedance of ZAB into ZAC upon the summation of all three impedances, ZAB plus ZBC plus ZCA. Similarly for this impedance, you multiply this two and upon you add all these three. To get this, you multiply this two and upon add all these three. So this is how you get the star connected system. So once you have got the star connected system, you can also convert it back into the delta connected system. So to convert back into the delta connected system, let me say this is ZA, this is ZB, and this is ZC. So now I want to find my ZAB. So your ZAB can be given by ZA into ZB, or let me write it as ZB into ZC, ZC into ZA plus ZA into ZB upon, here we are having the terms A and B. So if you do, the other missing one is ZC. So put here ZC. This is ZAB and this is ZC, and here the product of each two impedances. So similarly, you will get all the impedances, that is ZBC, this upon, we will be having ZA, and ZCA, again this upon, you will be having ZB. So this is how you convert in the old fashion, but it is very simple, where you can replace the each impedance of magnitude Z and with the power factor cos phi. So this is all about the comparison and the load conversion between the star and delta connected systems. I hope you understood well. Please subscribe to our channel. Thank you.